curiosity in what she does as her job, but also personally. She learns independently and with others, and she has this wonderful team that she continues to talk about, her librarian team. She learns with enthusiasm. I really appreciated that although she was new to her role, she embraced it. She has this great team that she worked with and felt supported. And any time that I was stuck for needing somebody to help out, she was the first one there, always willing to help out, always smiling, always friendly. She has this beautiful, quiet calmness to her. She's caring and loving, and she loves her students. And I've gotten to know her personally as well in a few gatherings, and I loved her sense of humor, as well as her love for her husband and her new married life. Brianna Chu, we will miss you. Next up, Esther Kim. Can you guess what IB learner profile trait? Principled. She acts with integrity and honesty. She has a strong sense of fairness and justice. She respects the dignity and rights of people, and she takes responsibility for her actions and her consequences. And when I read that, I thought, oh yes, that is definitely Esther. Because she is fiercely loyal. She cares about what people think and feel and will defend to the end. She advocates for others and for herself and for her students. And she loves the sense of routine and order in her classroom. That is clearly evident how the students know their routines, but yet they know how much she loves them and are safe and welcomed. We are going to miss Miss Esther Kim, and for those of you that know or don't know, that she is going to be married this year. She was supposed to be married earlier, but COVID didn't cooperate. We wish you all the best, Esther. We will miss you, and we wish you success and happiness in your married life. God bless. And lastly, we have Irina Kravchenko, and Irina is, as you may or may not know, very, very pregnant right now, going to have a baby soon. So she is going to take that time to help raise the child, a little girl. Her name is going to be Eliana. Yes, Eliana, so they know it's a girl. So I chose risk taker for Irina because she came in a Jill of all trades. She was taking on things that she's never experienced before, and she was able to do them readily. She approaches uncertainty with forethought and determination. She works independently, and she also works cooperatively. There were so many times that we were in a bind, and she was able to coordinate and collaborate with everyone. She explores new ideas, innovative strategies, and she's resourceful and resilient in the face of challenges. We love having her here at GSIS. She is this beautiful, calm, quiet spirit who is always smiling. She really loves the younger kids, especially the younger kids, but she loves them all. But she is trying to get her teaching certificate, so she was in the kindergarten doing her Teach Now practicum and online with her online videos teaching the kids. It was so clearly evident that this was a natural for her. She is loved by staff and students, and we're so proud of her, and we wish her the best as a new mom. And I don't believe she's here right now, but we wish her all the best. Maybe she's up there in the window. All right. God bless Irina and her journey. Thank you, everyone.
Good afternoon. My job today is to say farewell to some pretty amazing secondary teachers. And collectively, all of these teachers have given many years of service to GSIS. As well as my words, I share with you the words of others. Our thoughts, best wishes, and prayers are with you all. as you prepare for your transition to a new life and a new future. Numbers 6, 24 to 26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Joey, we've got the slides. Olivia Chan. So I followed Ms. Lajoie's example of going with the IB learner profile, and of course Olivia, it had to be balanced. Teacher, head of department, volleyball, basketball, badminton, MUN, green club, praise team, etc., etc., etc. It's actually going to be hard to imagine a GSIS without you. You came here as a young teacher and you told us all that your story the other night. In the process, you become a confident, articulate professional who has a great future ahead of you. And some of the words I use at the end come from other people as well. Thanks for always loving GSIS, loving the teachers, and most importantly, loving the students at the school. I pray that you have a fruitful marriage. May God bless you. Olivia, thank you so much for everything you've done. Miss Jean Che, hopefully she can drag herself away from the food for a little while. Of course, balanced. And someone wrote, Jean is GSIS. She knows the history. She's always making GSIS a better place. Jean, over time, has filled many roles, elementary student life, lower secondary counselling. She's been a VASE leader. She's been the PTA faculty rep, an Ignite leader. She's run those Ignite sessions frequently. She's run Snack Shop during sporting events. Her amazing baking and cooking skills. And I know from talking with people, Jean, everyone suffered the year that you're away. PD food just was nowhere near as good, apparently. Jean is patient and she has love and care for the students. Jean is described as a steady boat on top of the turbulent waves that have shook GSIS. She has a Christ-like love and care for everyone, enduring through many hardships and trials. And Jean, someone mentioned that you're probably going to be on speed dial for everyone next year. Thank you, Jean, for your service. I pray that God would bless you on your way. Thank you. Please come forward. Hina Chung is not with us today. She has already commenced her leave, but I'll describe Hina as reflective. Hina is one of the teachers who's dedicated to everything that she does, and even this year took on so many different challenges in her teaching load. Hina is one of those people that's always willing to say yes. She has an incredible passion for teaching and for the students. And someone wrote, as a fellow colleague and a parent, I so appreciate her high-energy classrooms and passion for her subject and students. Thank you for your heart for our students. We say thank you to Hina for the contribution she has made. Jayatika and Ronnie, I want to share some thoughts on both of you, first of all. And many people have said there's a very strong spiritual focus with Jayatika and Ronnie. Over the many years, they've always volunteering to take time to disciple students, outreach club, treehouse, VASE, Ignite, discipleship, gift club, Bible study groups. Jayatika and Ronnie, you have shared with us your four amazing, beautiful children. And as someone wrote, incredibly well-behaved children. We in secondary in particular have been really fortunate to have your two older children with us on their journey here. Thank you. To Jayatika, obviously a very clear communicator. Jayatika is calm and caring. She's diligent in putting so much time into her lessons so they're relevant and interesting for her students. Jayatika sees the best in everyone. She's dedicated herself to guiding students and being there to support them. and has been part of the amazing growth of so many students. She has such a strong personal relationship with the Lord, and this is evident in everything she says and how she lives her life. Jayatika, we're blessed to have had you with us. Thank you. Ronnie LaRoche, clearly caring. Ronnie's been a mentor and spiritual guide for many. He has a sincere heart for the Lord, a genuine concern for others' relationship with God, and an authenticity that is respected by others. He's been a Vida Nueva small group leader for the past 2 years. As a D teacher, he spends many hours after hours helping the students, getting them through to late at night so they can actually finish their projects. Ronnie has had a positive impact on so many students' lives. You've been a leader both as a teacher and as a follower of Christ. With great sorrow that we say goodbye. Ronnie, please come forward. Misty Skidmore, of course, we have to say a communicator. Fun-loving, enthusiastic, outgoing, great sense of humour, incredible storyteller, student-centred, an encourager, determined, multitasker, highly respected by students, parents and faculty, a boilermaker, passionate, a leader, open-minded, an incredible teacher. Most memorable instances that people have of her great teaching was that of a Japanese student who spent the summer teaching English. We've heard today about many of your achievements as well, Misty, and I know you've shared those very proudly with everyone in the school. Misty always goes over and above to be the very best that she can. Praise God that He brought you into our lives for the last 3 years, that He's made such a fine teacher. We will miss you. Misty, thank you. Arvind and Srija both have given long and dedicated service to GSIS. And over the last few years, good timing. Over the last few years, staff have shared in seeing their beautiful daughters grow as well. And we know that you two are starting a brand new adventure in Canada. Very exciting. Arvind is a very generous person. Whenever he travels anywhere, the staff say that he comes back with a gift for everyone in the department. Arvind has provided encouragement and a kind smile whenever it's needed. Arvind expects high effort and quality work from his students and from his colleagues. He doesn't accept mediocre. He pushes others to apply their best effort. Arvind, thank you for the care and concern, particularly that you've shown to the SEN students. And I know in some of the interviews I've been in, that incredible care you've shown for individual students. We thank you for the support that you have shown them. Arvind, thank you. Please come forward. Srija brings leadership, organisation, empathy, humour and knowledge to all of us. Obviously, a thinker. And Srija, the fact that you were chosen as the baccalaureate speaker the other night said a lot about that as well. Srija loves her students, and she's also described as a wonderful colleague. She's been encouragement both as a friend and a fellow English teacher for the other teachers, and her absence next year will be noticeably felt. Whenever I needed a little encouragement, she listened attentively, and I was the centre of her focus, no matter how busy she was. I'm very sad to see her go. It's a comment from a colleague, but I think it's also a comment that would be very applicable to students. I wish you all the best for her, Arvind, Evelyn, and Yvonne, and trust that God will continue to bless and provide for their family as they have blessed us here. Srija, thank you. Thank you to our secondary teachers who've been with us for your amazing, wonderful service. Thank you.
Okay, we have just one departing Korean staff. She's Ms. Reika Kim. She has worked at the library only for more than 10 years. And it is she who make that current beautiful library with other librarians. With her excellent Japanese language skill, she helped Japanese parents for translating and adjusting their life in Korea. She also sometimes made a delicious snack for Korean staff and make them very happy. Now she's leaving the GSIS. Reika, we'll love you, and we're not gonna forget you, and we pray for you. Reika, can you come forward?
And our final staff member to say farewell to is Mr. Joseph Kahn, who's been with us this year. And in some ways, it's really hard to fit him into a category. He's been an art teacher. He's sent numerous emails about helping out with events and so on. In particular, he's done an amazing job with the Charlotte's Web set, which we really didn't get to quite see in action. Next year, when he's not here, we will actually get to see that, won't we, Jeremy? Yes. Joseph Kahn, thank you so much for the service that you have given GSIS. I know we kind of stepped you in a different direction away from your normal career, but we really appreciated what you've done. Please come forward. We're going to move on, but if you'd like to just take a quick break, stretch your legs, grab some more delicious food if it's there, we'll take like a 2-minute break. Ladies and gentlemen, we might make a start. If you could take your seats again, please. Let's begin. Good afternoon. Dr. Penland, Mrs. Penland, Epak Sarnim, GSI staff and faculty, and all of those who are joining us today from hopefully various parts around the world. My name is Tony Carmel, GSI secondary principal, and along with Ms. Michelle Lajoie, the elementary principal, welcome you to this very special occasion. Dr. Penland, keeping this a secret has been really hard for everyone, particularly when you walk into the office in the middle of a meeting. This afternoon, we are here to say farewell to Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland, and particularly pay tribute to Dr. Penland for the vision, wisdom, and guidance that he has provided the GSIS community. We know, as it is very clear today as you look around, I'm going to ask everyone to stand and show your T-shirts. Dr. Penland has devoted his life to maximum impact for God. And we also know that Mrs. Penland has been with him along that whole journey as well and provided amazing support. To both of you, thank you. Thank you. Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland, this afternoon we say thank you. Please sit back and enjoy the tributes that have been prepared for you.
I would like to start today with a prayer. Let us bow our heads together and pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity for us to gather today in your name to celebrate today one of our most humble servants in your name as well, Dr. Penland. We ask that you bless Dr. Penland and his wife, Mrs. Penland, as they embark on a new chapter in their life. May you continue to guide them and protect them as they strive to do your will. May you keep their family safe from harm and continue to bless them with love and joy. And dear Lord, we ask for your continued guidance and protection during this difficult time of COVID-19. We pray that you will shield us all from harm and keep us healthy and safe. We also pray for safe travels for all those who will be traveling this summer, taking time to refuel and to reconnect with family and friends. We are grateful that we have this time, Lord, as we know many around the world are not as fortunate as we. How blessed are we? Lord, you give us so much all the time, and we'd like to thank you for all our blessings and gifts that you bestow upon us. We recognize that each and every single moment, event, breath, person, and experience is given to us as a gift from you. We trust that all that is brought to us is of your will. We will not fear, for you are near. For as it is written in Philippians 4:6-7, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. We trust in you, Lord. We ask all of this in your name. We pray. Amen.
The This afternoon has been a combined effort by many people, and we're going to be led in our worship at the moment by a number of people who are, hopefully we can all join in as well. Thank you.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. Born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. 예수로 나의 구주 삼고 성령과 피로써 거듭나니 이 세상에서 내 영혼이 하늘의 영광 누리로다. 이것이 나의 찬순이요 이것이 나의 찬송일세. 나 사는 동안 끊임없이 주를 찬송하리로다.
퍼펙트 서미션
all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. 주 안에 있는 기쁨으로 마음의 풍랑이 잠잠하니 세상과 나는 간 곳 없고 구속한 주 보이도다. 이것이 나의 간증이요 이것이 나의 찬송일세. 나 사는 동안 끊임없이 구주를 찬송하리.
This is my story.
This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior.
Let's sing that one more time. This is my story.
This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the
praising my Savior.
Praising my Savior all that
one last time.
Praising my Savior all the day long.
We are so blessed. What beautiful talent. Thank you. At this time, I would like to call up the people to help with the presentation of the history of Dr. Penlin. Jenny Kim, Helen Jiang, Jean Che, Joni Cho, Nurse Kim, Andrew An, Esther Kim, Grace Yu, Ryan Delos. And while they are coming up, what does 4 factorial equal? 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, 3 times 8, 6 times 4, 2 times 12, 1 times 24. What is the common answer? 24. 24 years ago in 1996, Dr. Penland graced us at TCIS and GSIS. Here is the history of Dr. Penland.
The history of Dr. Penland in Korea began in September 1996 when he was appointed as the headmaster of Daejeon Christian International School. In September 2006, he founded Gyeonggi Suwon International School with Gyeonggi Province and Suwon City. GSIS was the first one-to-one laptop school among MSN HS in Korea. In addition, GSIS was the second Apple school in Korea.
In July 2007, granted WASC accreditation, the first and only school in Korea to be accredited by HSI with 1 year. An amazing achievement. July 2009 became Association of Christian Schools International Board of Directors member and has served continuously through May 2020. In March 2009, first base trip to Nepal and Thailand. And April 2009, granted IBDP authorization.
In November 2010, we hosted the ACSI ICE Asia Conference with Central Christian Academy, CCA. And then in March 2011, we were granted the IB PYP authorization. May 2011, we had our first GSIS graduating class of 68 students.
In June 2012, we were granted IB MIP authorization. We are second IB continuum 3 program school in Korea, CCIS first. And now we are currently one of 9 Christian IB continuum 3 program schools in the world.
April 2015, we granted a synchronous WASC and IB authorization. November 2018, we hosted a Corpus Teachers Conference.
Dr. Penland is founding member of CAYAG Head of School Association, currently longest serving head of school in CAYAG and in foreign school in Korea. 2015 hosted Simpson University Graduate School and Master Degree Program on campus.
Some other notable actions are that he was the chairperson of CAYAG HOS Association for two separate terms and one interim term.
Yeah, Dr. Penland, he served as a visiting committee member or chair for WASC school visit in Iorkus for every year for the past 24 years. Completed over 30 WASC school visits in 24 years in Iorkus.
Another notable action, he has served as a chairperson on WASC and IB synchronous visits for 3 different schools in Iorkus. He assisted with development of the Masa Ati Tribal School in Boracay, Philippines.
Dr. Penland, it's an incredible history and incredible legacy that you have left the school and this country as well. Thank you. Hopefully our technology is going to work and we have all of the people connected whom we need to connect. We're going to move on to a segment of speeches of tribute. from special guests who are joining us today. Our first one is Dr. Lee E. Pak Sanim. Dr. E.J. He is the Deputy Chairman of the Hyosung International Education Foundation. He can't be with us today and apologises, but he does have a video tribute for you. Miss Grace, maybe we should have left you playing some lovely keyboard music in the background for us while we're waiting. And maybe this feels like the very early days of Zoom lessons as well, trying to get all the connections working. And we have a couple of videos that we do need to share today as well. Mr. Jackson, you could have just played throughout.
Let me take you back to the beginning, to when I first met Dr. Pillen. I decided the leadership at GSIS for the opportunity to honor Dr. Pillen. I decided to attend the International Job
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Jay Lee, the Vice Chair of Hyosung International Education Foundation, a former board member of TCIS Foundation. I am extremely honored to talk about Dr. Pelland, who I respect and love so much, upon his farewell. I'd like to talk a bit about what he has done here at GSIS. Of course, he has done so much for the last 14 years at GSIS and 24 years in Korea that I cannot enumerate all. Dr. Pelland has devoted his life to teaching and serving as a great and respected model Christian educator in the United States, Malaysia, and Korea for 30 years. Also, he has been actively engaging in various missionary and volunteer activities in Korea and other Asian countries. He has been a well-known great Christian leader representing not only Korea but also East Asia, serving as an HSI board member representing East Asia. In 2006, together with TCIS board members, he established GSIS to train talented students who will lead the future in the spirit of the love of Christ. Dr. Pelland made GSIS an enjoyable high-quality school by incorporating the IB program successfully into our Christian International School system, so that the students at GSIS can fully open their dreams and grow spiritually and intellectually in a balanced manner. As a result, GSIS developed to the one of top international schools in Korea. He always encouraged students to cultivate holistic abilities. He is a great educator who cherishes students based on his excellent personality and Christian philosophy. He consistently treated the staff like a family with a warm heart and meticulous consideration. As a board member working with him since late 2011, I can testify that I observed him working so hard to harmonize diverse stakeholder groups' different ideas. I remember that he often was more than willing to give up his own benefits for students, parents, staff, and faculty to have more benefits. Sometimes he had to make tough decisions that might have been misunderstood by the people who he had helped and loved so much in the past. Sometimes he had to be alone in difficult times, and although people staying beside him have gone, leaving behind all the problems they created, like in the difficult time in 2011. But even in difficult times like that, he faithfully performed his duties and stayed calm throughout the process. I saw his unshakable faith in God. I believe he often prayed in the tears before God. I believe God's words and prayer were the only things he could get strength from. Through the time I have worked with him, I could find the true meaning of a great leader, which can be defined in the relationship with other members who he leads, and the relationship with God. It was a great honor that I could meet him and work with him for the last 8.5 years. And I confess, it was God's wonderful grace in my life. Now it is time for us to drop everything and say goodbye, leaving both beautiful and painful memories. It is so sad to send this fine young man away. We want to keep him forever, but we know everyone has their duties and missions to do. Maybe now is the time for him to have another new mission given by God. Finally, Dr. Pelland, congratulations on your honorable retirement. Thank you so much for all the contributions and sacrifices you made for GSIS. You'll be the eternal founder of GSIS, true leader, warm mentor, and loving friend to me and everyone else at GSIS. I pray that your life wherever you go, continues to have maximum impact for God, as you have here. Bless you.
Next up, we have a video speech from Mr. Rod Wallace, the first principal at GSIS.
Good evening, GSIS family. I would like to thank the leadership at GSIS for the opportunity to honor Dr. Penland, one of the best leaders I've ever had the pleasure of working with. Let me take you back to the beginning, to when I first met Dr. Penland. I decided to attend the International Job Fair at University of Northern Iowa in February of 2006. I was looking for an administration position. During the first day, I was offered a job from a school in the Marshall Islands. I had called my wife and she was excited about going to the South Pacific. After speaking to the school's director of human resources, I told her I had one more interview with a school in South Korea. She said no problem, as she thought there was no way that South Korea was going to beat out the South Pacific. 3 hours later, I called my wife and asked her what she thought about South Korea. I believe she had already packed her flip-flops and bathing suit ready for the South Pacific. I told her about my interview and about the headmaster, Dr. Penland, I had met. I said that after talking with Dr. Penland, I felt South Korea was where God was leading me. Dr. Penland told me that he would let me know in a couple of weeks on whether I would be heading to TCIS as the middle school principal or to the brand new school, GSIS, as the founding principal. When I got the call from Dr. Penland and he told me that he wanted me to become the founding principal at GSIS, honestly, I was a little unsure. I had never opened a new school, but this is where Dr. Penland shines as a leader. He has a way of motivating, inspiring, and assuring you that he has faith in you to be able to do the job. For this, I am truly grateful. I appreciated the trust he showed in my leadership as GSIS opened her doors. There were nervous times as only about 100 students showed up for the first year. I remember a particular parent meeting I had with some of the parents, and they were asking if GSIS was going to be able to provide the education that would prepare their children for the best colleges in the world. I was drawing on the board in the GSIS conference room that academic plan for their children to succeed. I remember seeing Dr. Penland walk into his office. He looked at my presentation about the educational future at GSIS. I fully expected him to open the door and take over the meeting. He did not. He turned around and went to his desk. The amount of trust he showed me in that moment, I will never forget. Because of his faith and trust in me and the GSIS staff, GSIS grew to an enrollment of approximately 400 students. I remember some of our discussions about the direction and vision of GSIS. TCIS was a school with a 50-year history. Their community and traditions were well established. They were very successful, largely due to Dr. Penland's leadership. I believe that many leaders would have demanded that GSIS duplicate all things that were TCIS. Great leaders like Dr. Penland understand that you cannot copy everything from another organization. Other than the vision of becoming an IB school with high standards for academic success based on Christian beliefs and values, Dr. Penland allowed GSIS to become its own school. Under his strong Christian-based leadership, GSIS quickly gained the reputation of offering a high-quality education with an intentional Christian worldview. We became GSIS. We became a family. We were the Knights. This was all accomplished because of Dr. Penland's vision and faith. Dr. Penland had already served many years as the head of TCIS, and one would understand if he favored TCIS. I never saw that. At the joint staff retreat in 2007, the GSIS staff, led by our own Andrew Ahn, and some very strategically recruited new teachers, beat TCIS in the staff soccer game. Dr. Penland showed exceptional leadership skills at the next combined administration meeting by congratulating GSIS on their victory and informing the TCIS administration that they better up their game. GSIS has faced many challenges. Through all of these challenges, Dr. Penland never wavered, never lost his faith, and continued to be a strong and righteous leader. Dr. Penland, on behalf of the original GSIS staff, I would like to thank you for your leadership in guiding GSIS to becoming one of the most respected international schools in South Korea. It is because your leadership and your faith in God, GSIS continues to provide a high-quality Christian education to its students. Personally, I would like to thank you for your confidence in me and bringing me on board to start GSIS. For Sherry, Alexandra, and Christopher, and myself, you and Shirley, for always welcoming us into your home. I pray that God directs you and Shirley into this new chapter of your life. You have left a great legacy here in South Korea. Not only did you lead one school to the highest echelon of international schools, you led two. Thank you again for your Christian leadership you have shown to all the employees and students that have been fortunate to learn from you. See you on the golf course.
Dr. Penland, we now invite a friend and colleague, Cho Songbok, GSIS Business Administrator, to speak to you.
Dr. Penland, first of all, congratulations on your honorable retirement after 14 years of GSIS and 24 years in Korea as a Christian educator. Thank you, Sherry, and your help of for accompanying you for those times. I have been working with you for 8 years and confirm that all those praising words about you from students, parents, teachers, and staff I have met. You have impressed everyone around you, like your life motto, maximum impact for God. You were always passionate, humble, and kind to everyone, from kindergarten kid to senior student, from staff to the all outsiders. I believe it was true power came from total interest in God. I have been moving around from US to Korea because my wife is a US Army soldier. I was teaching and working at the Woosung University in Daejeon earlier. Then I dropped everything to go with my wife and went to the Washington DC. Then came back to Woosung University. When I found out the business administrator position was the bacon at GSIS, I immediately knew that I perfectly fit this position. And after almost 2 hours of the long interview, I was hired. And I was so happy and was ready to work with all my might. When I met you, you started praying first to God, and it was very impressive to me. No matter what you do, you pray for God's help that impact me to be grown. For the last 8 years working with you, I remember a lot of fun, but I also remember I was against your opinion or plans a couple of times. Please don't get me wrong. I never distrust you. I just try to pursue my duties in legally and officially right way instead of warm heartedness. Unfortunately, for a long time, legal issue dealing with the Suwon City and the Gyeonggi-do became my main job. I do not have much knowledge in legal matters, but I trust you and GSI was on the right track. So I have put all my energy to support you. I cannot understand all the difficulty you have been through, but I believe God give mercy and grace to his children.
who entrusted him with everything. As you told, God sent us many faithful people to help. I also thank them from the bottom of my heart. Now, legal issues are resolved, and the GSIS has homework to do maximum impact for God. Even if you go all the steps, we'll try to make GSIS to the best Christian international school. It was the greatest blessing I have met you in my life, and I hope to see you at least a couple of times a year. Bless you and love you. Wherever you go and whatever you do, continue to live your beautiful life of maximum impact for God. Thank you, Dr. Pellan.
Next up, we invite Mrs. Che to speak. Mrs. Jean Che.
Two weeks ago, I was cleaning out my computer and I came across a letter that Lois had written to Dr. Penland as she graduated from GSIS. I like to share that story with you, that letter with you, part of it, not because it's Lois's story or it's our family's story, but I believe it's a story of many of our students and some of our faculty. She writes, "About 8 years ago, I was homeschooled in a country that I was unaccustomed to, where I struggled against this language barrier that disabled a lot of my schooling options. My siblings and I longed for an English-speaking school that we could afford and attend. In the early spring of 2006, my family took a trip to TCIS to support my mom for a job interview she had with you. I was 10 years old, and I fully understood what it meant if she became a teacher at this new school. It meant that I would get to go to school. It meant that I could play with other kids whom I could actually converse with. In that hour while we waited outside, I prayed that my mom would get the job, and she did. So as we headed back home, we went to Suwon in search of this school. When we got there, we realized it was just a construction site, but it will be our new school. There wasn't even a place to park, but my dad stopped the car in the middle of dirt road where our family prayed. We thank God for GSIS, a place that we all knew held boundless possibilities for our family. It was your vision for GSIS, Dr. Penland, that allowed me to go to school in Korea, and for that, I am immensely grateful. GSI has changed my life because it isn't just an educational institution. It has been a home. It has been the place where I found God and his purpose for me. That's more than any diploma or scholarship I could walk away from this school with. Since that time, that 10-year-old girl first walked into Mr. Tennant's fifth grade class, I made friends from all over the world. I made it into the varsity soccer team in seventh grade and have been playing since. I picked up the bass and have been playing in chapel since eighth grade. I got to be part of a missions team to Myanmar and Boracay. I even acquired the spiritual courage to start a club, Treehouse, for my friends who wanted to know more about Jesus. Boundless possibilities. That's the school that you set out to establish, one where God would show its students the boundless possibilities of his great and perfect plan. And that is the impact that you have had, not only on Lois, but many of her students. And I hear some are in med school, some are going to dental school, some are teachers, some are YouTube stars, some, there's one working for Google, just boundless opportunities. The vision that they were given here at GSIS. I recently thought about What if Dr. Penland didn't answer God's call to start this school, GSIS? And I thought, his life would have been so much easier. He wouldn't have to travel all the way from Daejeon 2-3 times a week. He would probably have more time to play golf and definitely more time to spend with Mrs. Penland. It would have been a much easier life the past 14 years, I'm sure. But Dr. Penland, because you did answer to God's call and you were obedient, you've made such an impact on our students' lives, on our teachers, on our families, and they're spread out all over the world right now. And that impact that you made on them are impacting the world right now. So I just pray, Dr. Penland, that you will never doubt that you have made maximum impact for God at GSIS and in the world. We will miss you.
GSIS를 만나게 하신 하나님의 섭리에 감사드립니다. 교육을 통하여 하나님의 복음을 전하기 위해 오신 닥터 펜랜드를 기억합니다. 학교의 미션과 필라서피를 세우고 선생님들을 세우시고 학교의 모든 시스템을 체계화시키시고 IB 프로그램을 학교에 도입하시고 학교 기초를 세우고 아름답게 완성하셨습니다. 닥터 펜랜드에게 감사를 드립니다. 당신의 지혜와 정보와 열정과 비전 또한 삶을 한국의 교육을 위해 헌신하셨습니다. 주님께 닥터 펜랜드를 위해 기도를 드립니다. 이 모든 일로 말미암아 그를 기억하여 주시옵소서. 그가 행한 선한 일을 기억하여 주시옵소서. 그의 삶의 은혜를 베푸시고 평안으로 인도하소서. 주님의 나라의 일로 평생에 힘썼다고 인정하여 주시옵소서. 다시 한번 닥터 펜랜드를 축복하며 감사를 드립니다. 이대 PTA 회장 손영화. 이대 PTA 회장 손영화.
And Dr. Penland, I'm sure that message also comes from many of the PTA presidents, PTA executive members, and PTA members over the years to pay tribute to you. And now I'd like to introduce a video from the classified staff that Mr. Ahn has organized as a tribute.
Okay, so what we are doing now, we are going to show you video tributes from various heads of school. Mr. Brumsicle, Dr. Liso, and Dr. Caldwell.
Dr. Penland, I want to say thank you for all of your service and work that you've given to TCIS over the years, and I remember about 20 years ago when I first met you down there at TCIS, and we were both coaching basketball and you tried to cheat all the time because the floor was always a home court advantage. Lighting was such that it was just downright awful. But I look at TCIS now and where you've come, and you don't cheat anymore, but you run two very good schools. And it was a real honor for me to work with you, and it was a real blessing to have our friendship. So from India, I just want to say congratulations, and I hope you and Shirley can get out and really enjoy your retirement. I know you need some work to improve your golf game to certainly compete with me, but anyway, good luck. I hope you have some time and some good time, and God bless. Thank you.
This opportunity to participate in the tribute that GSIS has created for you as you prepare to depart Korea. I suspect that you had no idea when you arrived at TCIS in 1996 that your involvement in Christian International Schools in Korea would span 24 years. Having had the opportunity to negotiate with the Korean government myself in the establishment of a second school, I had great empathy for the almost insurmountable challenges that you faced as you sought to bring GSIS into existence. And yet, your commitment to ensuring that the international community in Suwon had access to a quality Christian international education brought that vision to fruition. And then I had the opportunity a few years ago to actually be on campus and to see firsthand how your vision was being implemented by the extremely dedicated and capable Korean and international staff that you had assembled. So as you and Shirley prepare to conclude your time in Korea, I hope you do so recognizing that through you, God has richly blessed hundreds of families who have been a part of the GSIS community. And I pray that God will continue to bless you both with an enriching and satisfying retirement.
Greetings from North Carolina. I'm Dwight Carlbloom, and my wife Lori and I had the amazing fortune of being able to work with Dr. Penland and Shirley for a number of years. They are the ones that met us at the airport in Malaysia when we first went into an international school at Dalat International School back in 1981. We were with them for years there, then we joined them at TCIS in 2003 for a couple years, and then joined them up at GSIS a few years after, 6 years after that. And it was just, what a blessing to be able to work with these two people. And being able to watch how Dr. Penland served as a head of school, the heart that he had, the compassion he had, the desire for an exceptionally strong education that he had, I hope has impacted how I serve as a head of school. Couldn't be happier. Looking forward to hopefully seeing them in North Carolina this summer. Congratulations, Tom.
Dr. Penland, Mrs. Penland, of course, with the impact of COVID, your family couldn't all be with us, but I'm sure they have a very special message for you at this time as well. We share that with you.
Hi, this is Darren and Laura Price. I worked at GSIS from 2006 to 2012 as an administrator. Laura is Dr. Penland's daughter. I remember when GSIS first started and we first embarked on that journey in Suwon, and it was really a God thing that Suwon even started and GSIS began. And even before the school opened, there were many challenges that took place, even through the construction process and the accidents that happened around that, to the first years of the school. It seemed like every time there seemed to be some positive momentum, there would just be new challenges that came up, either through something that happened in the community or something that around the campus. And I really believe that that was an effort to stop what God had for GSIS. And Dr. Penland has been faithful, and we appreciate your faithfulness to lead the school through some challenging times and continue to be persistent in doing what God has called you to do and what God has called GSIS to do. So thank you and congratulations. on where GSIS is today. We look forward to how GSIS is going to impact the kingdom and continue to make a difference for years and years to come. Congratulations, Dr. Pinlan.
We love you, Dad. We're proud of you, and we wish you well, and we'll be praying for you as you move on.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Granddaddy. We love you so much.
Love you, Granddaddy. Congrats.
Happy retirement.
Go ahead, Thomas.
Happy retirement. I'm looking forward to playing more golf with you, like we did that summer with Keenan, Ethan, and me, and you and my dad. That was very fun.
Happy retirement. I am looking forward to giving you big hugs this Christmas once I see you again.
Thank you.
Oh, when I arrive in the green mug, I'm in front of
you. What did you say? Say it one more time.
Happy retirement.
Happy retirement, Granddaddy.
Happy retirement.
We love you.
Happy
and
retirement,
have
Granddaddy.
A great time.
Congratulations on your retirement. We love you.
Congratulations on your time at GSIS. You've worked really hard, and we are proud of you, and we are excited to start retirement.
Big P, Dr. Pinlan, Tom, congratulations. We love you so much, and I personally look forward to many, many, many prayer walks with you in the future. We are so proud of you, and we love you, and congratulations again.
Congratulations.
Love you.
Love you.
Hi, Granddaddy. Congrats on your retirement. Thank you so much for everything, and I can't wait to see what you do in this next stage of life.
Congratulations, Granddaddy, on retirement. Thank you for all the wonderful memories.
Dr. Pinlan, congratulations on your retirement. It's been a great ride, and I'm looking forward to seeing what God has for you in the coming years, coming months, coming weeks. I still think we should have been the GSIS tree frogs, though.
Dad, we're so proud of you, and we're so excited for this next stage. Thank you for always just modeling such concern and care for students and for staff and for your community. You've been such an example to each of us in our lives, and there's so many of your qualities and your traits that we each would like to emulate. So thank you for the example that you've set for us, and we love you, and can't wait to celebrate you with you in person.
Success for the future. In my opinion, the exams are not the learning part, it's just sort of the signature to all of the learning that's gone on before. And until March 23rd, you didn't know you were not going to take an exam. And if you think between March 23rd and April 30th, you can study enough for 2 years to do that exam, you and I know you've got to be kidding. 2-year course of study and program. So I'm very confident that you're, just like every other cohort here, you will go on to college and university, and you'll discover that your IB experience and learning experience here has prepared you very well. And you'll, at some point, look back and say, well, there was pain, but there was gain. And I'm prepared to do my work at my next school, and I know what they're talking about and what they're looking for. So I want to encourage you with that, and I believe in you more than any other class, and you're the first class in the history of GSIS to do virtual education for almost the whole second semester, and to stick with it and to do your work and do your IAs, get all that uploaded, and get that taken care of. Thanks a lot to Ms. Jenny Kim, Mr. Cartwell, and to all of those who supported you and got you here. So congratulations.
Soon dissolve like snow. be forever mine. You are forever mine.
What a beautiful, beautiful video and beautiful music. Speaking of music, it is now time to invite Mr. Jackson. He is going to play A Child Is Born for us on the piano.
ask my fellow administrators to come forward, please. We need to share some gifts with Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland. Would you please stand? Dr. Penland, Mrs. Penland, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We have some gifts to share with you. I'm going to ask Mr. Cho, first of all, to present the plaque to Dr. Penland. Kyung-Yi Suwon International School, GSIS, expresses appreciation to Dr. Thomas J. Penland, founder of GSIS, September 16, 2006, well done, good and faithful servant. Dr. Penland, that is your copy. There's one in the lobby. We have some more.
Oh, you better even start this.
We actually have a whole Korean dinner set for Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland. It's a little bit much to bring all of it down here now. Dr. Penland, we all thank you from the bottom of our heart. The microphone is yours.
Thank you. You can be seated for just a moment. I'm not going to take long, but... So, in four words, I think I could simply say, GSIS changed my life. I remember the first year talking to the new staff and talking about TCIS and all that God had done to bring TCIS to help it survive when it should have closed, when they were down to 69 kids, and the missions wanted to quit and just say, we're done in Korea, there's no need having MK education anymore. And it failed by one vote on the board. Close the school. That was before my time. And I kept sharing everyone about that and saying that GSIS was a school opened by God, and that God would write his own story in the school. What I didn't know is that I was going to be a part of the story for that long. And there were several times, to be honest, I wanted out of the story. And several times when I thought I might be out of the story. But GSIS is God's story of a place where he decided that the gospel should be taught and spoken on these grounds, talked openly, and that children would learn that there was a God that really loved them. And coming to know that God could change their life, the same as he's changed all our lives. So God in his plan, not my plan, made this happen. After I'm long gone, don't talk about me, talk about God. The gentleman over here, the young gentleman over here with the sunglasses, he's from the government. Not really. He knows the truth of the story. Let me share three verses and I'll come back to that gentleman and his story. Three verses. Matthew 19:26 says, "But Jesus looked at them and said to them, 'With man this is impossible, but with God all things are possible.'" In Mark 10:27 it says, "But Jesus looked at them and said, 'With men it is impossible, but not with God, for with God all things are possible.'" And in Luke 18:27 it says, "But he said, 'The things which are impossible with men are possible with God.'" You know, in the Bible, when they quote Jesus three times, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, it's pretty important what he's saying. And if you recall, in this situation, it was the rich young ruler. And the words he said before that was, it's harder for a rich man to come to the kingdom. It's more difficult than to put the camel through an eye of a needle. With man, this is impossible. With God, it's possible. The plain facts are, as I told God, "No, I don't want to do this." I told him that several times. "I don't want to do this school in Suwon." I told Mr. Che that when they came down the first time. I told him I didn't even want to meet with him. He's a persistent man. It was Friday afternoon. It was late. I was in no mood. And he sent somebody up to say, "Come down and meet with Mr. Che." And I said, "No." And then he came up. He said, "These are government officials from Gyeonggi-do, Suwon, could you please, or Gyeonggi-do, can you please come down?" And I said, "Are they, do I really have to, Mr. Che?" And he said, "Maybe," which means yes. We came down there in his office and they made the green tea and it was still boiling hot and I started drinking it because I wanted this to end. And the long and the short, Mr. Che was there. I told him they were at the wrong place. I don't think he translated it, but I told him that in English. They were at the wrong place. They were wasting their time. They needed to go back. The traffic was getting bad. And I said, finally, I said, "You know, first of all, I don't make a decision. I work for a board. They'd have to decide. They're not going to be interested. It has to be a Christian school. It has to do the IB. We have to be able in charge of the management of the school. It's a not-for-profit, and we don't have any money." Mr. Che, I think, translated most of that. And then they said something back in Korea, and he translated back to me, and he said, "That's why we came." And God began to work on the no part. And I started listening. But then I tried, God said, "Okay," and then my TCIS board didn't want to do it. And they said no. No. And most of TCIS didn't want to do it. "You're going to hurt the boarding program. You're going to hurt TCIS. What are we doing?" You remember, Mr. Che, they didn't want to do it. But God wanted it to be done and wanted this school open. I didn't want to do it. It changed my life. And it's been the greatest thing ever. Not the school, the experience of learning to trust in God more than ever. Learning to say, I can't fix anything. It's all a wreck and a mess. And I can't do anything about it, and I don't even understand what all's going on. But Jesus, I'll trust you. And I'll try to do what I think is right. And God brought people around me that were angels. He brought people into my life that I never knew. Whenever you're in your life and you're at your most difficult time and you pray to Jesus, He will bring people into your life and it'll be like miracle workers. We were blessed, but we were so challenged. Like they were saying, First Principal Rodney and Darren Price, and every we take two steps forward and one step back. It seemed like, you know, we got the school open. We were having PE in the basement. We had dorm and apartments. And Chuseok Holiday came and the whole swimming area collapsed over there. Construction worker was killed. Another one lost his leg. So many tragedies, but God was in control. Right up there, I got a call. My friend Brent Frazier was having the first of several heart attacks. As I drove from Tejon up here, I prayed to God to spare his life. Jesus, don't take Brent now. I need him. I was talking to his wife in China. God spared his life, healed him, he was able to come back to work, continue to serve. God's mercy. But then Mark Pash got sick and God didn't spare his life. My friend Joe Frambro spent the last conscious hours with Mark getting a message to his for his children. His children weren't really following Christ, and they came here to our school, and the love that they saw at our school totally knocked them out. In 2011 began chaos in my life. Chaos, and then I had to make a decision. So what I thought was right. And when I made that decision, I knew there would be a price to be paid. But God made it certain that I knew what the right thing was at that point in my life. journey began through a time of deep trial and distress. Not being able to help the school very much, just pray for it. But God sent in men and women to help. And in my stay, they did their best. Everyone served to the glory of God. And there, we went into years of uncertainty. Chaos, God was in control. In suffering, God was in control. In uncertainty, God was in control. There are people who I'm looking at right now and that suffered as well. It's okay to suffer. In fact, the Bible says count it all joy when testing and trials come, because it's going to produce perseverance. Yes, GSI has changed my life. It changed me into a man that depended more than ever on God. It humbled me. It challenged me. It confused me. It stretched me, and it consistently rewarded me. For the last 2 years, I've been able to read the senior Bible papers here, and they're just incredible. What God is doing in the lives of our students is quite phenomenal. You think that it's all done while you're here, but it's not. I was sharing with my administrators. I had my farewell a week ago Sunday in Tejon. And on Monday evening, I'd been up here and I came home and it was tired. I think I got home about 8, it was 8:30. I checked my email, and there was an email from a graduate of TCIS from 2001, 19 years ago. I was his Bible teacher. That's another thing GSIS took away from me. I had to give up teaching Bible. That was my thing I loved the most at TCIS, Senior Bible. And I couldn't do it. It wasn't fair because of back and forth between the schools. That was one of the hardest things for me to give up, because I loved that time with the kids. This student from 2001 was my son, one of my son's best friends. He left the school an atheist. He became a strong atheist at Purdue, where he was in engineering. He went on to a career in engineering. He moved from atheist to agnostic, to Buddhist, to Zen Buddhist, to a spiritist. And about a year ago, he decided to go back and read the Bible in the book of Revelations, which I taught in the senior Bible class. I don't always recommend people looking for Jesus to go to Revelations. He did. Because God then gave him visions. From the book of Revelation and reading it, he would have visions at night, and he knew that it was his time to make a decision. As I read that email, he told me in the last 3 months how he had made peace with God, was following Jesus, was on a YouTube channel telling people about how Jesus had changed his life around. He couldn't be quiet about it. 19 years later. You're just getting started, GSIS. Just getting started. God has so much more he's going to do here. Just stay faithful. What's next? Don't know. God is in control. I do know that. I don't know what's next, but God is in control. He's always in control. We doubt him, but he's in control. He's given us something to do. Cultivate, form, grow. Internationally minded learners. We need internationally minded learners today in our world. Some of our cities are burning. Internationally minded learners who lead and serve for the glory of God. That's what you're going to do as long as God keeps you here. You're going to touch hearts. You're going to provide exemplary education. You're going to provide life-changing service experience. And you're going to trust Him with the plans for the future. Where am I going? I don't know that. People ask that, but I believe with my whole heart that today, tomorrow, the next day, the next year, whatever time God gives me on this earth, I want to have maximum impact for God. I don't know who stole my phrase or how they got that, who started. It's not something I created. When I was about, I got to figure it out, 27 or 28 years old, I was at the Lot School. I was a young administrator there, way too young. And Arnold Cook, who was head of missions for an organization in Canada, came to speak in a chapel. And he said in that chapel that his mission statement, that he had decided to take a mission statement for life. And his mission statement was maximum impact for God. And somehow God just made it that night so clear to me. And so the reason I stayed in Korea 24 years is because I felt like I was having maximum impact for God. And that impact was not by me alone. It was through you, through us together. Loving kids, praying with kids, teaching kids, showing kids, giving opportunity to kids. So keep it up, and I'll come back and check on you. Make sure you're staying on with the mission. I love life. I don't know what God has. I'm so blessed, and all of you know, I way over married. She's the blessing of my life. She just, you know, she says, are we going to live in a backpack the next year? I want to go to Boracay and work with the Ati and over to Malaysia and do some volunteer work over there and go into China a little while. And she's like, I said, well, we can have more than a backpack, but we'll probably be moving around. We'll see what God wants. I want to follow Him. I thank you. This is a very honoring evening. I know a lot of people put their hands in. I know Helen Jung is always part of it. Jean Che, Tony, Michelle, Thongbo, your kind words, all of you, Dusty, the music, the praise team, that our preacher guy over here has a really nice voice. Pastor Beck. Yeah. The young preacher guy we hired, you know. I love Joseph. Great man. So that's it. It's, as I said in Tejon, it's not about me, it's about Him. So talk about God, don't talk about me. I'm really quite tired of it. I really appreciate it, but they need to take the banners down and we need to move on. And I know I've appreciated it. It truly means a lot to me. I don't mean that in any disrespect. My wife will probably talk to me on the way home. I shouldn't have said that. But I love you. But I love Jesus, and you know he's the real thing. That's all I can say. And if you don't know that, you got to figure that out, because it's something great and exciting, and He never fails, and He doesn't disappoint. So God bless you. Thank you.
Dr. Penland, we're going to close in prayer. And I know we need social distancing, but it just feels like people actually need to come closer and maybe gather around Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland. It doesn't quite feel right to do a prayer of blessing with everyone there and you there. So if you'd like to come forward, that would be lovely. Just come right forward. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we hold before you your servants, Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland. We give thanks to you for their witness, their service, and their dedication to spreading the gospel in your name. We give thanks for the time that they have given in serving the GSIS community. We pray that you will continue to bless them as they prepare to leave GSIS and Korea. We pray that you will continue to guide and protect Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland, and that they will always be richly blessed. We give you thanks for this community and for all those who have gathered here today. We pray for the future of Dr. Penland and Mrs. Penland. Be with them as they move on to the next stage of life. We say to them, go in peace to love and serve the Lord. We ask these prayers in Jesus' name.